this is like, this is our mecca of barefoot water skiing. This is it.
Definitely like power, horsepower, speed, energy. I like to do things full force, all out, all the time. It's kind of hard for me to slow down sometimes. If I am challenged by health, I find a way to get healthy. I'm a professional pilot for a living. It was during a training event I started not feeling well. Over the next few days when I was in the hospital, they did a lot of additional testing. And lo and behold, they found that I had a low-grade glioma. And I knew kind of right away that my career was in jeopardy.
Hey, Dave.
We met with four different neurosurgeons. And Dave really liked Dr. Weingart, liked his manner and his directness.
He also has worked with the FA before, and he has done surgery on other pilots that have brain tumors. So he's aware of the protocol with the FA. It has to be out of there before they'll even consider me flying again.
Because it was sitting in his language area, that surgery is best done with the person awake at surgery. So we had a fairly extensive conversation about, you know, what awake surgery was like and how that would transpire. During the surgery, there's a sort of a three-way conversation going on between Dave, the anesthesia person, and myself.
I'd say one, two, and then I couldn't talk. They had moved off of the tumor onto brain material, and then when they moved back, I could talk.
It's a way to get the maximal amount of tumor out, minimizing the chance of having a speech problem after surgery. So for something in this location, you know, and it's essential. Dave's recovery was great because there's no general anesthesia hangover that occurs. He was out of bed that evening, walking around the next day.
They have a special neuro ICU.
It's nice to be here for a visit, not as a patient.
Which was also really helpful because we knew that the staff was dedicated to the care with neuro patients. So that was really helpful to us because we felt like he was in really good hands.
He was out of the hospital in 2 days and felt, you know, cognitively normal when he went home. So his, you know, outlook is fantastic. He should be able to get back to work. He's safe to fly. I mean, he's a perfectly normal person at this point.
But honestly, for me, I mean, I think I came through with flying colors. My life has not really changed at all, other than now I am a brain tumor survivor. I think I'm one of the lucky ones.